Come on. Come on, Master Gardeners. Hey, I've been hiking down this trail and I found a plant that's native. I wonder if you know what it is. It looks like a grass. It's not a grass. This happens to be a rush. A rush? What's a rush? Rushes are plants that are in the Juncaceae family. It's a small group of flowering plants. These are evergreens. Flowering plants, monocots, just like your grasses are monocot, just like your sedges are monocot. This family are called rushes. This rush rushes all up and down the trail that direction and that direction, and it loves these compacted soils. And oddly enough, this particular rush likes it when it's really wet in the winter and then dry in the summer. Isn't that an unusual life cycle? But rushes, have you heard of them before? They have roundish stems. This is a plant that sometimes is brought into our Harford County Extension office and people wonder what it is. It's often in horse pastures where the horses are traipsing back and forth in the poor soil. So this plant really likes disturbed soil. So come on, let's take a little bit closer look at it. That family of Juncaceae is not a very big family. It only has 8 genera in the whole family. And it has, I think, 464 species. But there it is. You can see it's a very erect, light green color. It's in seed right now. It's already finished its flowering and it's in seed. You know, plants are put into groups by their flowers. That's what makes that's why even though these look like grasses, they're not grasses because they have a different type of flowering structure. But this guy is called Juncus tenuis. He's poverty rush, or he's also called path rush is another name. Actually, he has plenty of common names. Slender rush, slender something else rush, but anyway, lots of rush names. But as you can see, these are the seeds. These are the seed pods that are coming up. The inflorescence is born on the top, and it makes these grassy, leafy little leafy bracts coming out of the top. You just saw my fingers pull down on one. Let me show you one on the paper here. It's a nice view of one. Look at the leafy. So there's your inflorescence. Inflorescence just means the flower structure, or the structure that actually holds all the flowers. And you'll see you always have these two leafy bracts. Here's one coming up right here, and then the second leafy bract right there. So that's a real common feature of the flowering structures, is that leafy bract. So that'll help you identify it. Another way to identify it is its stems are actually very hard to mow. So when it's coming up in your along the trails and they have to mow these. Now I chose this spot because it doesn't have any, they're not mowing back in here, but it's all covering the right side of the trail and the left side of the trail. But when the lawnmower doesn't have a sharp blade, man, this guy, it'll just stick right up. But this is a native plant all through Canada, all through the United States, everywhere. So it's very common. It loves infertile soils. So if you're having a problem with this particular plant in your horse pasture or in your yard, you got to begin with a fertility program. So you need to go to your extension office and get a hold of how to do a soil test in your yard. But it has bright green foliage, round stems, and it's flowering June through September. As it ages, it gets a straw color, which is what you'll see here. So this is already sort of worn out. See that straw brown color, but it loves to grow in disturbed soils. So that's why it does so well in your horse pasture where there's a lot of mud and compacted soils. The leaves on it, the leaves, which are, they're always down at the base. I'm not so sure I can zoom on it, but the leaves always come out of the bottom 1/5 of the plant, the bottom part of the stem. So very confusing with grass, but you'll always see this is much more rigid, much more erect, and then it has the leaves that are real thin, and they're really kind of stem-like, the leaves themselves. So there you go, a little zoom in on the foliage. So let me just compare it to right over here. I wasn't going to spend much time on sedges, but I got a couple sedges coming up. Let's find one in flower here. There he is, right here next to my sign. Look at these flowers. Oop, don't put your hand in front of there. So this is a sedge. Now when I reach out to grab this sedge and I put it between my fingers and I roll it in my fingers right and left, look, it's got a leafy bract on it too. But when I roll this flowering stem, it's got angles. If I were to cut it into a cross section of that particular seed head, that would have edges on it. So the way you memorize this is sedges have edges. and that'll help you learn what your sedges are. But it's another whole group of plants that are not flowering, or are not grass, but they're in the monocot family with the grasses. And we find that our weed killers don't behave the same when they're used on rushes and they're used on sedges. So a whole different class of flowering plants. So there you go, poverty rush. Did I tell you the common name? Poverty rush is the name of this. So I want you to get out in your local park. You go take a hike. See if you can find some poverty rush on your trails. They're everywhere.